Instead of always waiting to be led, there comes a time when you should lead.
Yeah.
So what do I mean by this? I'll give you another personal example. Steve Cornell, my joint CEO and myself, came into position in July last year. And we always wanted to introduce ourselves to the ministers and what have you in Pretoria. We are supposedly the biggest industrial company in South Africa. Could not get an appointment.
Sure.
So Charlotte, our executive, who's sitting in the audience here, Nqwena, I said, no, we'll change tact. Instead of going to Pretoria, we'll deal with our host communities. So we'll work with the communities in Sasolbek, we'll work with the communities in Secunda, improve their lives, make sure they have a truly a better life. The politicians will find us on the way. I'm not going to wait for a politician. So the message I'm saying to you is take charge and lead, they will find you on the way.
What I know that is not resourceful is to allow yourself to be consumed by what is happening outside in politics, in government. I'm sure all of us, we know you can spend the whole dinner talking about the Guptas and whatever. You can literally spend the whole evening talking about state capture and those things. So I look at it in two ways. As leaders, what is it that personally we can do even with those frustrations? So the first thing is that we sometimes project a lot to say, look at what the government is doing. Look at what is, yes, there's a lot of frustration, but with the power that you have right now, what are you doing to change your environment? So the second part is that, yes, as a citizen of South Africa, you then make a decision that what is your own active citizenry? There are many organizations, some of them in the room here, who are NGOs who have decided that they will create and mobilize people to say, let us stand up for our country. So I'm saying that you can do as an individual and collaborate with people who are leading such organization that let's change our country. And at the same time, don't point fingers. Do it where, if you are a CEO, if you are an executive director, what are you doing yourself to lead transformation? So I think that's the, because after talking about all the frustrations, we all know it's very draining and tiring because those conversations don't lead you anywhere. You just get frustrated at the end.